La terapia intraarticolare delle artropatie, oltre ad avvalersi dei presidi più ampiamente conosciuti, primo fra tutti l'acido ialuronico, sta esplorando anche nuove frontiere, tra cui la terapia genica. Ne parliamo con il professor Evans della Harvard Business School in occasione del congresso ISIAT di Roma.
Professor Evans, could you please explain the theory about intraarticular gene therapy?
Yes, so the idea is that we exploit the ability of the gene to direct the synthesis of RNA and protein molecules that could be therapeutic. And by putting the gene into the joint now acquires the ability to make these products endogenously. So we've effectively converted the joint into a factory that makes its own medicine and is producing its own therapeutic products. And the one that we've been focusing on is the interleukin-1 receptor antagonist, which blocks the activity of interleukin-1, which we consider to be an important mediator in joint diseases.
And how to convey the gene into the interarticular space? What do you use?
Right, so we use what's called vectors that are just agents that get genes into cells, and they can come in various forms, particularly non-viral vectors and viral vectors. We've concentrated on viral vectors because they're much more effective, and the ones we're looking at in terms of human use are adeno-associated virus. We have previously used a retrovirus in a clinical trial as well, but we're now moving over into using adeno-associated because it can be directly injected into the joint and it should be much safer.
Which data you have already collected in animals?
Right, so we've used animal models of both rheumatoid arthritis and osteoarthritis in various different species, ranging from rats through up to horses, actually. And in each case, we've noted a dramatic therapeutic effect when we put the gene into the affected joint, whether it's a rheumatoid joint or an osteoarthritic one. So in animal models, it works very well.
And so you see the inflammation decrease. Which data you see that demonstrate the efficacy of?
Well, it has a very powerful effect on protecting the articular cartilage. And one of the reasons we selected interleukin-1 as a target to begin with was that we knew that this molecule was a very powerful inducer of cartilage breakdown. And by using a receptor antagonist of interleukin-1, we've been able to preserve articular cartilage. We also see an anti-inflammatory effect, which is most clearly represented as a diminution in the synovitis, and also a decreased volume of synovial fluid and less leukocytes in the synovial fluid.
Let's go to human. Which data you have collected in human being?
Well, there's been two small studies in rheumatoid arthritis. One involved 9 patients that we did in our institution, and a small study involving just 2 patients in the University of Dusseldorf in Germany. And the collected data show that we can safely transfer genes into human joints, these are rheumatoid joints, without any complications. When we do this, the gene is expressed within the human rheumatoid joint and is the gene product is active, so the IL-1RA is made at an elevated level and does what it's supposed to do, namely block IL-1. Neither of these studies were powered to detect a therapeutic effect, although we did see therapeutic reactions in a number of patients, including one that responded very dramatically and very quickly, but that's anecdotal. It's not been subject to a seriously powered study that was specifically designed to look at efficacy. That has to come in phase 2, and we've only done 2 small phase 1 studies.
And what is necessary to start phase 2 studies to overcome the difficulties to do this very high-tech therapy?
So we're fighting this battle at the moment, so I can tell you what the news is from the battlefield. So basically, it's a matter of convincing the authorities that in America, where I work, this is the FDA, of course, that the procedure you want to do is safe and that it makes sense. And so this usually involves looking at what the material does to experimental animals, where it goes to, how long it stays, and various things like that. Once you have the regulatory permission in place, the actual performing the study needs careful planning, because the vectors, the viruses that carry the genes into the joint, have to be made to very high clinical standard in GMP facilities, which is complicated and also very expensive. And then after you've manufactured a safe clinical grade virus, actually performing the study is very simple. It'd be like using any other therapeutic that you inject into the human joint, and then you use whatever outcome measures that you would otherwise use to study any form of arthritis, in this case osteoarthritis. The only probably additional thing you do because of the gene therapy is to look for things like antibody to virus and various other things connected to perhaps persistence of the virus in the body. But the biggest hurdles are the administrative regulatory compliance issues and making the clinical grade virus.